how to know if you are eligible for government tender. Government tenders have the ability to increase your business tenfold, but for that, you need to know if you can get government tenders for your business. The world is moving towards digitization, and so is our country. Indian government has completely digitized the procurement system with the e-procurement module. It is to promote transparency and efficiency in the procurement of goods and services by various government departments. From the year 2012, the Central Public Procurement Portal has been made mandatory for all the central government, central public sector and autonomous bodies for their tenders offering. If we go by definition, a tender is nothing but an invitation for bids for a specific work. So when we talk about government tenders, it is government department which invites bid for a particular project for a specific time period. Our government offers a huge number of tenders in different sectors like health, agriculture, infrastructure, etc. Now the question is, what the criteria is to qualify for government tenders? Let's have a look at them one by one. Every tender has its own specific eligibility criteria, but that being said, there are some general and highly essential criteria that have to be satisfied by the bidders. Registration in e-procurement module. This is the most basic criteria. If you want to work with the government and bid for the tender it releases, visit the government e-procurement website and register your business. It may require some specific documents about your organization, so keep them with you while registering. These documents are a registration number, Aadhaar card, PAN number, TAN, etc. Digital signature certificate. This is also one of the most basic requirements for a bidder. He has to obtain a valid digital signature certificate DSC for signing and encryption of Class 3 DSC. This digital signature certificate has been made mandatory by the government to perform e-procurement. Technical and monetary criteria. A bidder needs to provide certain information about his organization that comes under technical and monetary criteria. These criteria include annual turnover, production capacity, company credentials, past performances, equipment, quality control, after sales services, etc. The financial background also serves an important role to the government. A bidder needs to quote a certain amount for the said work and the time frame to complete it in. A bidder also needs to pay a non-refundable tender cost or earnest money deposit, a refundable amount. It may sound a bit tedious to fulfill the criteria when you read it all at once. You might do some of them on your own and you might need help with some of them. It is possible that you are unable to spare time to tick every checkbox given in the book. In all of those cases, you need to someone to rely upon. National tenders provide end-to-end service for the tender information, vendor registrations to tender submissions. Don't miss out on a golden opportunity to work with the government. Contact National Tenders now.